I am fortunate that I have been able to guide many, many students about how to prepare group discussion. Those students who had Hindi medium background like me have been able to speak well in English group discussions. Because we Indians can learn any language and speak with fluency, with competence, with confidence. We can learn any language of the world and speak with full confidence. Our mother tongue is Hindi, but due to some or other reasons, we have been forced to think that Hindi is not a good language. We have been forced to think that in modern context, we need to learn English so that we can progress. Somehow, the world is yet to realize that for artificial intelligence, Hindi and Sanskrit are very good languages. And in future, if software development and artificial intelligence can take place in Hindi or Sanskrit, probably English will soon be outdated. Probably. Once the software development takes place in Hindi or in Sanskrit language, the accuracy of these languages is so high. The accuracy of these languages will enable computer softwares to work better. And once people of the world start adopting Sanskrit and Hindi as their principal languages, they'll find that artificial intelligence will go to new heights. So, I personally believe that in the interest of the entire world, we should immediately start learning Sanskrit. But so long as this dream gets realized, we have to learn English and other languages so that we are able to immerse with the international community. Today, the world is one. All political boundaries are now flimsy. We are living in one world. And we have to work with people from different countries. So, if you want to work in a company in which people from 20 countries are working or 30 countries are working, you need to develop your competency in spoken English, in cross-cultural understanding, in ability to respect diversity. And therefore, you have to change. You have to adapt. You have to understand and appreciate their cultures. You have to understand and appreciate their languages. You have to speak the way they speak so that your chances of selections are increased. Why should a company select you? Because the company wants to select a global leader. Company wants to select a person who can show leadership to employees from 20 countries, employees from 30 countries. And you have that capability. Therefore, there are chances that the company may select you. But if the company wants to select you, company also wants to ensure that it is recruiting the right person. So group discussions, interviews, discussions, informal meetings, these are important means to judge your personality. So if a company is taking an interview, they are indirectly judging your personality. They want to know about your attitude. They want to know about your knowledge. They want to know about your skills. They want to know about your habits. They want to know about how you behave with others. Are you a very short-tempered person? Are you a very egoist person? Do you really listen to others? Do you really respect others? Do you really help others in creating a team. So companies want to know about you. I firmly believe all of you are real gems. But you have to prove that you are gems in your group discussions and interviews. During group discussions and interviews, you have to show those skills, those competencies for which the company is willing to recruit you. List down all the qualities in priority which the companies are looking for. What are the qualities the companies are looking for? The companies are searching for leadership quality. Highlight it in your actions, in your behavior. Don't say you have leadership quality. Prove it in your behavior. Show it in your nature. Show it in your group discussions. Companies are recruiting you for your communication skill. Prove it in your group discussion. Prove it in your interviews. Companies are recruiting you for your positive attitude, for your proactive nature, for your collaborative nature, for your innovation-seeking nature, for your nature of supporting others, for your clarity of thought, for your ability to organize an excellent team. Now, you have to prove these qualities in GD, in group discussion, in interview. Don't say you have these things. Prove it in your behavior. People want to see the things from their eyes. How will you show it? You get an opportunity in group discussion. You get an opportunity in your interview. Of course, in biodata, you can write it down that in terms of your qualities or in terms of your competencies, you have these competencies. You have competence, you have leadership competency, you have strategic thinking, you have a team building ability, you have ability, you have outstanding communication skills. You can write these things in your CV. You can write these things in your LinkedIn profile. You can get them endorsed by others. Fine, this is what you can do to make an impressive resume, to make an impressive social media page. But when it is a group discussion, you have to show it in your behavior. So how will you change your behavior? Through your own regular practice. Create a regular practice, show in your behavior, you have these things, and thereby you create a chance for your selection. So, dream big, aspire big, and achieve amazing results. Don't leave any opportunity to add to your biodata. You may add degrees to your biodata, but more important than degrees are your other contributions. You get an opportunity to work as volunteer for, let's say, ICAI Jaipur. Work and take voluntary experience certificate. Add it in your biodata that I worked as volunteer for so-and-so organization. They have appreciated my work. This is their appreciation letter. It will help you. It is a documentary proof that you have leadership ability. You have concern for society. You care for the society, you care for the world, you are a responsible person. This is the documentary proof. People want documentary proof. Why should people select you? You have these documentary proof. Look, I have these things. So, build these things over a period of time. Over a period of time, you should have these credentials. If there is any conference on leadership competence, participate in that. Take a certificate. If you can speak something, fine. Otherwise, be participant. You can put in your biodata, I participated in so-and-so conference, which was on leadership competency. I learned these things from this conference. If there's a workshop on team building, participate in that workshop and add in your bio data. I participated in the workshop on team building. Companies want to recruit the best people. You are the best people. You are the best. But you have to prove that you are the best. You have to show an evidence that you are the best. You have to show it to the employer that you are the best. You have to show it in your behavior, in your GD and interview, that yes, you are the best. How will you show it? Think about it. What proof you have? What competency you have? How will you support with document your competencies? What documentary proof will you offer to support your candidature that yes, you have leadership ability, you have communication skills, you have professional competency? What are your evidences? You have a degree that shows you have some knowledge, but people just do not want knowledge. People want you to have an expertise in skills, competencies, wherein you show that you have actually applied the knowledge that you have gained. Having understanding is not enough. Ability to apply your knowledge, ability to create knowledge is more important. So how will you prove that you are contributing? You are creating knowledge. You are knowledge creator. You are applying your knowledge. How will you prove it? So work on these strategies. I hope all of you will achieve remarkable progress. Remarkable progress. And I am always available for everyone. Not only for you, but for every youth. Any youth, if you come to know that person needs my guidance for interview, for group discussion, for other purpose, you can give him my phone number. You can give him my contact details. That person can contact me anytime and I'll always be there to help anyone across the globe. Best wishes. People, you people are going to create a better world. I know. But I want you to ensure that you respect Indian culture, heritage, and become a proud ambassador of Indian culture and heritage. If you become a CEO of a global company, you may live in any country of the world, but wherever you live, you spread Indian culture and heritage. It is world's best culture. For thousands of years, this has been the best culture. You carry this culture in your heart, in your mind, and live this culture with pride. Thank you all.